pretty much anyone who follows me online knows that I'm a fan of these AI text and image generation tools like ChatGPT, MidJourney, Raycast AI is a good implementation of ChatGPT. There's a lot of these tools that I find really useful and help me do my work better. And I think that there's a lot of potential for them to help us do our work better, to do it in less time, to just be more efficient in ways that computers always have. What I'm not a fan of is what I've seen a lot in the AI hype cycle of people talking up these tools as if they're more capable than they actually are, that they are more reliable, that they're actually smarter. They're smarter than they actually are. They're not smart. That's not what they're good at. That's not remotely what they are. But they do have some value, and I think that if you are letting your employees go to use ChatGPT instead, I think that's a big mistake. And if you look at what companies who have done that in the past 6 months have experienced, I think that you're going to see a lot of people who regret that decision. So I wanted to take today's video to not say this is how I'm writing my scripts in ChatGPT or how I'm outsourcing my creative process to this. What I want to show is how I'm using these tools to augment my work, to let me work faster, to let me do some of the work that I just genuinely hate doing and I'm not good at, and it's helping me get better at what I'm trying to do here on YouTube. So today I'm going to show you 4 different tools that I'm using to make my work better. One is called Transcriptionist, another is MacWhisper, those kind of do the same thing. Then there's Claude, which lets you upload files and then ask questions about them, which is really cool. And then finally, I'm going to use MidJourney to generate some images. Okay, so in this scenario, we have a video we've already created, edited, all the things, it's ready to go. So I've got this 7-minute video, and the best way to create free, high-quality transcripts, in my opinion, is an app called MacWhisper. I'm using the free version here. You can pay, I think, $25 to unlock higher quality transcription models, but I'm just going to use the free one right now, and it's going to start transcribing as soon as I drag in the file. I can drag in an audio file, a video file, basically anything with audio, it will go ahead and transcribe for you. And so it's going ahead and doing the transcription. It's half done already, so it goes pretty darn quick, honestly. This is on an M2 Pro MacBook Pro, but it's pretty quick on any Apple Silicon device. I've used this on the M1 as well. Totally fast, totally awesome. Real big fan of it. And it's done. And so I can kind of see the whole thing. You can do some translation stuff. You can break it into segments if you want. But what I want to do is I want to export it to YouTube as a subtitle file. So we'll go ahead and do export. Want to switch it to an SRT, which is what kind of the standard subtitle file format. And we'll export this. So we'll go ahead and just use the default, save it to the desktop. Cool. Now, that's really excellent. If you ever wanted to, we'll discard the translation there. If you want to upgrade, you can get higher quality models by upgrading to Pro. I think if I take a look at that, it doesn't say the price here, but it is, checking it live, 25 euros. So it's free, or you can pay 25 euros for one license. Then the more people using it, the more you pay. So again, that's totally free, and I got the file, and I can upload this to YouTube, and it's going to work great. That's what I've used for many of my videos in the past, like, 6 months. If we get out of this, there's another app that does a very similar thing, just came out. It's from the creators of Ferrite, which is an awesome app for the iPhone and iPad for editing and recording audio. If we open up this and say create a new transcription, it's a very similar situation. So drag in the video file, and we're going to go and start the transcription, and it's going to do the same thing, right? If I go into the settings for this app, there's an option for AI Brain. Defaults to tiny, and then I'm using the small one, which is similar to what MacWhisper was using, but you can actually go to these even bigger ones. Large, I've tried, takes a long time to process it, but it does give you really high quality subtitle files. So really happy with that, just it takes a little while longer. I should also say that the free version of this only will transcribe the first 2 minutes of a file, but if you want to transcribe longer things, you have to pay for a subscription. It's $3.50 a month or $20 per year, whichever you want, and I'm currently doing a free trial for the sake of this video. I don't know if I'm going to stick with it because MacWhisper, again, is free, and I'm pretty happy with what it's doing, so I'll probably just stick with that, but this is a really great app, and again, works on the iPhone and iPad, which MacWhisper does not. So we'll let this finish up here in a second, and I'll show you what I do from here. Okay, so it's finished up, and you can kind of just scroll through it and check out what it's done. It's pretty darn good, in my opinion. And when you're ready, you can just go ahead and go to export as, choose whatever file format you want. I'm going to do a subtitles file, so SRT, save it to the desktop. There we go. And so that's done. And again, you can save it to the cloud and you can like sync between your devices. Really cool. Really like this app. But again, it's not free to actually use. So MacWhisper might be more what I stick with long term. Okay, so now I have a video and a subtitles file I can upload to YouTube. I also need a video title, and I suck at titles. I hate making titles. It's my least favorite part of the video process. But you need to do it. And so what I use to help with that now is an app called Claude. And Claude is like ChatGPT, but it has one big difference, which is you can upload files. And I need to actually convert this. So I usually make a duplicate, change the extension to TXT, and then I can go ahead and grab it from here. If I try to upload the SRT, it's gonna throw an error. I don't know why I'd wanted to do it again, but there we go. So I've got the file exported and uploaded, and I'm going to give it a prompt. And so I actually just copy and pasted this. And I said, this is a YouTube video script that talked about why the Apple Podcast app is actually good now. I want a video title that's classy, but not clickbait, but also enticing. Give me 10 suggestions. Right, that's a ChatGPT sort of thing you would do, but it's using the transcription we just created. So it knows what I said in the video, and it can kind of figure out what sort of titles I'm looking for in that case. And so, okay, it gave me 10 of them. I can give it, have it retry. I can have it like adjust based on that, you know, all the ChatGPT things. So I like this because it helps me come up with better video titles. And I usually don't use these exactly. I usually use one that I like and then tweak it to work for me. I just find that convenient. And that's really, really nice. Now, we can hit the limits of this pretty quickly if we go to make chapter markers for this video in the format you would use in a YouTube description, right? So I want it to create chapter markers for me, automatically generate. So, okay, so it starts generating them, and these are actually generally the headings that I would use. Yeah, like these are kind of the things that I found interesting or that I talked about, and they're not totally right. Sometimes they're better than others, but what I found, and I'll have it retry just while I talk, what I found is that this is a great example of how these tools do not know what they're doing. They know what sounds right. And you can see it's formatting it differently this time. It's giving me different titles. These aren't really the things that I would want to talk about. But anyway, sometimes it's better than others. But it has no idea what time these things happen. If we actually go into the video, you'll notice it's not right, it's not correct, and so it's not useful there. So that's definitely frustrating. But again, if for things that are super like specific and need to be accurate, these tools aren't that great. For things that are just inspiration and kind of get you something that's close and then you can get it the rest of the way, I think they're really good. And then finally, image generators. I won't do a full demo here because I made a whole video that walks through this. I'll put a link in the description, but I use MidJourney a ton. You can kind of scroll through all the things I've made. I use this to create backgrounds for thumbnails. I don't use it to create the thumbnail entirely because I find it creates just insane things, but I use it to create assets like backgrounds and stuff that I can use. Again, link in the description, so I won't go into it anymore here today, but that's it. Links to everything I talked about in the description, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye.